performance today?
Not good enough, but good enough to win. Not good enough because I think we have to play better and in a more consistent way. But good enough to create four or five big chances. Good enough to keep Hugo in a very quiet evening, and good enough to win the game. But not good enough because we have to play better than we did.
Can you tell me what you thought of Fulham's performance? You predicted they'd be full strength and strong, and they were, really.
Yeah, I knew. Of course, they start the Premier League in a way where they were intelligent enough to understand that way they would be relegated. And then they changed on time. They adopted a different way to sing football, a different way to organize the team. And since then, they are getting good results, which I always thought that I was expecting a difficult match.
Okay. Gary Cottrell.
As you predicted, it was a pretty unchanged Fulham side. I think one change from the last Premier League lineup. So seems like all that fuss was a little bit about nothing before the game.
Look, I truly believe, I have to believe, and I know the top hierarchy at Fulham Football Club, and we are dealing with honest people. And of course, they had problems. Of course, they had problems. And of course, the reason why we didn't play the game when we should, there were reasons for that. Okay, let's put that very, very, very clear. The reason why they were not happy to play today is a different question that you have to ask Scott and not me. But, you know, in the football world, it's very difficult to keep secrets. It's somebody that tells somebody that tells somebody that tells somebody and arrives to another somebody. And of course, we knew for a few days that they were ready and they had the players to come, and Mitrovic is not a COVID situation, is a small injury from the last match. We knew that. So it's something that you have to ask Scott, but make things very, very clear. Of course they had problems, and of course there was a reason for them not to play the game a couple of weeks ago.
How much is it a worry at the moment that you're not killing off these games? And is it up to the other players as well to give Son and Dane a bit of help? Because it feels as though if they don't kill games for you, nobody does at the moment.
Look, I understand that in the first half we had chances to kill the game. Some of them is Areola's responsibility. In the second half we had the biggest chance to kill the game. But when you don't do it, you cannot concede goals the way we did it. And this is the same story basically since the beginning of the season. We can speak about not killing the game. Yes, we can speak about that. And today was a clear situation that we should and we could kill the game in the first half. But then you go back to the goals that we concede, and it's not also easy to assimilate that.
Going on from that, in terms of the goal you conceded, how angry does it make you when you play so well yet you just switch off for a second? And what will you say to your defenders after the game?
I think there are things that have to be with the characteristics of the player, of the players. There are things that is difficult too. Some things they have to do with the organization of the team. But other things, they have to do with individual skills, individual ability. And there's as simple as that.
All right, guys. Thank you very much.
Thank you.